Today, I will explain how the EBEs are calculated in Monolix. The calculation of the EBEs is the second task in the Monolix interface. EBEs stands for empirical bias estimates. They are also called postdoc estimates or conditional mode. The EBEs are the mode of the conditional distribution for each individual, so the most probable parameter value for each individual. If this curve represents the probability density function of the conditional distribution for the volume of individual I, the mode is the value having the highest probability, so the peak of the curve. So we are looking for the value that maximizes the conditional distribution. As a reminder, the conditional distribution represents the uncertainty distribution of the individual parameters given the individual data yi and given the population parameters which are omitted from this equation for clarity. Actually, I have several parameters, for instance ka, v and cl, so I will write them psi I with psi a vector. The difficulty is that the conditional distribution has no closed form solution. So the workaround is to use Bayes' law and to write that the conditional distribution is actually equal to the probability of the data given the individual parameters times the probability of the individual parameters divided by the probability of the data. Because I'm optimizing this formula with respect to the individual parameters psi, the denominator is constant as it does not depend on psi. Its value is complicated to calculate, actually it is the likelihood, but it does not matter. When calculating the EBEs, it is constant, so I can ignore it and find the EBEs by optimizing only the numerator, like this. The two terms that remain have a closed form solution. They have been explained in detail in the video of the week 111. In brief, the first term is the probability of the data for individual I given the individual parameters. It depends on the model prediction F and the observation model. For example, here is a formula when the observations are described by a normal distribution and a constant residual error. The second term is the probability distribution of the individual parameters within the population. The example formula here is for a log normally distributed parameter. So I need to maximize this function with respect to psi. The maximum is a point where the gradient is equal to zero. But calculating the derivative with respect to psi of this expression is complicated because psi is a multidimensional vector impacting the model prediction, and this prediction may be the solution of an ODE system, for instance. So what we do is to use a common deterministic optimization algorithm called net-domain simplex. It is a direct search method that does not need the derivatives. This algorithm will be explained in detail in a future video. Two settings of this algorithm are available in the graphical user interface and can be accessed via this button. The first one is a maximal number of iterations of the net-domain simplex algorithm for each individual. The second is the absolute tolerance criteria. The algorithm stops when the change of the value of the function between two iterations is less than the tolerance. These settings actually do not need to be changed. Note that when all the tasks are run by clicking on the Run button, we first run the population parameters, then the conditional distribution task, and finally the EBEs. This is because it enables to use the mean of the conditional distribution for each individual as a starting point for the net-domain algorithm. If the EBEs task is run individually before the conditional distribution task, an approximate mean calculated over the last iteration of the SAM algorithm is used as a starting point for the maximization. So to wrap up, in the EBEs task, we calculate the mode of the conditional distribution, which represents the most probable individual parameter values. In the conditional distribution task, we estimate the entire uncertainty distribution by sampling from it, and compute summary statistics such as the mean. As a side note, if you wonder why we don't use the samples from the conditional distribution to calculate the mode, it is because to get a precise value of the mode, which is multidimensional, many, many samples would be required due to the curse of dimensionality. This would take much longer than running the Neldermet simplex algorithm. Have a nice week!